sold more records than any around the world than any other solo artist alive. This is something, 100 million records. I don't know how many albums, gold, I'm telling you, and he's single. I'll tell you this, you get three teenagers with him. You want to keep that in mind. You did not sing, let me just take a moment, you'll fill in the blanks and pretend like you're, you know, I know you've talked about this before. He didn't sing until he was 25 years old. That's a stunner. You were a soccer player.
Mm-hmm. Bad, very bad one.
Huh?
Bad one.
You're a Madrid kid. With your father was a physician, your mother was a writer, I think.
No, my mother just take care of the children.
I see.
That's enough. That's enough.
And it was an auto accident that almost left you paralyzed.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I shouldn't be doing the talking here. I feel a little guilty asking you to tell this story again. But you were 20, I believe, at the time.
20 years old.
Mm-hmm. You thought maybe you'd never walk again for a while.
I never lose the hopes, but I it could be. I thought in the beginning that I could never walk again, yes. That's difficult.
You had a compression of the spine, not to be confused with a break.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. So you worked at it, and you got a guitar. Soccer was over.
Uh-huh.
And what did you do, win a contest?
Everything was over.
You thought?
My life was over.
Uh-huh. Did you win a contest, did you not?
I started to play the guitar and I started to write the songs and I went to the contest in Spain and I couldn't even reach the orchestra at that time, so I just counted the bars as much as I could in that time and I went on the stage and I sing the song. That's all I did. And I'm here now.
And although soccer was over, a whole new career was ahead for you. Did you performed in Beijing?
Yes, we were in Beijing last week, and we sang in the television for the first time in my life.
In Spanish, English? In what did you sing? In what language?
Well, we sang in Spanish, of course, because it's my mother language, and English too. I don't think they understand anything even in Spanish or English, by the way. But it was a great, great time in China.
What was the response like? I mean, how were the... was this an amphitheater or was it a studio? I know you say you were on television.
It was a studio like this. And it was the first time they broadcast some Occidental artists. And in the beginning, it was like everybody was concerned what I'm going to do on the stage. Mm-hmm. And after that, after 10, 15 minutes, they start to get involved in the music, and they were nice people, very, very, very nice people.
Uh-huh. I don't understand how you kept your head after all this. You know, to be almost bedridden, you at a time in your life, when you were early 20s, you walked on all fours. At night, you tell us that your parents would go to bed, and you'd walk just, I've got to walk.
Yes.
You went from walking on all fours to all of a sudden the number one star in Spain.
Well, it was more difficult than that, but but it was, you know, I couldn't reach anything in that time in my life, so whatever I do was trying to put my muscles against together for 2 years, and the only way is to doesn't make my family be concerned, and I was really in a bad situation. What I did is at night when they sleep, I used to walk like a cat, because it's the only way to feel that I could move around the house.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time develop my muscles, and it was something that helps a lot my morale in my life. Mm-hmm. By the way,
I'm glad you waited, caller. Go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Hi, Julio. You were on the Barbara Walters show a few years ago.
Yes.
And you said that you wanted to be a superstar in America.
I wanted to be known.
How does it feel to be a superstar in America? Because you definitely are one now.
Thank you.
Julio, I'd like to ask you, do you have any plans of getting married in the future? If you'd have...
Oh, that's an emotional answer, you know. It also depends of two persons, not only my answer. It's a... Well, you get married for the first time so young, like I get my ex-wife too. That's an answer of an emotional reason. Today, then if you ask me if I want to get married again, I think the brains and the heart has to be together in both persons. And I don't know, I don't have anything now to answer because I don't have anybody, so I don't know exactly. Mm-hmm.
You don't have anybody, huh?
Especially.
Well, let me speak for myself, and I'm sure I admire your, I mean, if anybody, you know, you could get married, and the fact that you haven't tells us that you are a man of serious purpose, who appears not to be capable of a foolish mistake at the wrong moment.
Well, as I'm concerned, then this is not an easy attitude to get married and to really be a deep marriage. Sure, it's very difficult.
Now, you've been divorced since 79. You will pardon us for our preoccupation with your personal life. This will only take a moment.
I don't know what's going on.
Now, here's a guy with a... they're out in front of the hotel. These women are in the lobby of the hotel. These women are in the elevators of the hotel, down the hallway to the hotel. Now you look to me to be... What? One show at a time. I think I can ask this without taking you into an area that may... Janis Joplin said, I made love to a million people tonight and went home alone.
That's interesting.
That describes you.
Well, you want to talk and to say then which is better, to be in front of an audience or to be in television and with all your feelings said to everybody, and you prefer your professional life than your emotional and personal life, I would say 100% yes.
You prefer your professional life consumes you now.
It's not only that, it's a need for me, and so I prefer to be in front of my audience and to enjoy that hours and to just feel younger in my body and my skin and to have my goosebumps and to really fight for that than to have a personal emotional life, for sure. Mm. Thank God.
You're saying thank God? Thank God you have this? And what, I'm trying to figure out what you're celebrating here. You're pleased that you don't have what? The luggage that goes with it?
No. I'm pleased that the life gift, that gift that makes rich people so quickly and in such a good way. And I will never miss that. I will never lose. I don't want to lose.
Right.
Not because I'm here today. Yes. I would want to be here.
Right. Well, if Bruce Springsteen is married, can you be far behind? That's the question. But we won't chase this any more than that, other than to say there is no woman in your life at the moment that would reach this kind of serious consideration.
But it's also two persons, Phil. It's not only that I have to say that. It's the opinion of two persons. It's the eyes of two persons. Say, I don't have that eyes, and maybe she doesn't have my eyes. It's something that... It's much more deep than that. If you're talking seriously, if I want to get married, if I have somebody to get married with, I have to answer not. If you ask me if I have somebody who takes care of me and I take care of her, maybe.
Taking care of someone does not necessarily mean a lifetime commitment, is I think the point. Yes, yeah.
Yeah. How did you enjoy working with Placido Domingo?
Well, I love him. I think he's one of the biggest ever singers in life, and it's like a learning from him. Yeah. I love him.
Does he have anything in common with Willie Nelson?
Yes, we have in common the emotions.
Are you planning to make any more records with
American artists? Well, I just did one with Stevie Wonder.
Stevie Wonder. Is the clip ready? I want to show you this. We have just a piece of that. That's first up, is it? Stevie's not in it. You can see, you can hear Stevie, but you can't see him. Which is something Stevie might be able to say about us. Roll this tape. Watch this. Julio Iglesias. Watch.
My love is warmer than a smile. My love gives to every needing child. If anyone should ask you who's my true love, tell them my love's true. He's ever letting all the love come through. My love sees love with not a face and lives to love through time and space. Full of everything about my love, it's to the tune of you.
You like that? And that happens to be in this album. Is this your 60th album? 60th? 60?
Excuse me, sir?
Is this the 60th album?
This is the second English album. And it's, I think it's the 68th album in my life.
I'm glad you called. Caller, go ahead. Are you there?
Hi.
Hi.
My mom adores you and gives every record you made. And my question is he seeing anyone now?
Well, you were probably chatting. We have already gone over that. We are going to, yes, he is seeing someone now. You've come a long way without my answering your question. Yes, you are seeing someone now. In a social way, huh?
Exactly.
To what do you attribute your success?
Well, I'm humble. Oh, you mean, sorry. You want to take a swing at that?
I don't think there is any logic. There is no logic for anything in my life.
Well, Leo, how long do you plan to be in New York City?
As much as you let me here.
I know you sing in different languages. Do you sing in Portuguese also?
And I sing in Portuguese, yes.
You do?
You fala português, huh?
Sim, senhor.
Eu falo português?
Muito bem.
Eu também.
Was that dirty? No. Well, you've got the lines jammed here for some unknown reason. Julio Iglesias is on the line. Hi.
Hello.
Go ahead, sir.
Yes, Julio, this is your Italian friend, Charlie. I'd like to know if you're going to go into motion pictures.
How long?
Films. Are you going into motion?
No. I'm the worst actor ever in life, so impossible.
I'd like to know if you write all the music and the lyrics to the words, to the songs that you sing.
Yes, until I start to sing in English.
Julio, I love your smile. It lights up your whole face. It makes you look so different. And I love Donahue.
Well, I'm sort of wondering if you had any other dreams besides singing.
No, sir. I think it's better in my life now to make people dream than even to dream myself, even if that's the most important thing. I don't have any dream more.
Yes. Julio. I think the movie that you made a couple years ago, or
the worst thing I ever did in my life.
For me, it was good.
He liked it.
I liked it very much. Personally, I think that you'll do good on movies also.
Where are you from?
El Salvador.
That's the good, because it was the only film in El Salvador at that time.
Yes.
As a representative from the National International Fan Club, I'd like to know how you feel about your fan clubs.
Well, first they fight for me. They follow everything. they put me, they, I'm very much concerned about that because without them, I will sing in the shower. So, I thank you very much, everybody.
How are you? I'm glad you called. Go ahead, Colin.
Yes, I'd like to say to Julio that I know he's very superstitious before going out on stage, such as clicking his heels and making the sign of the cross and whatnot. And I was just wondering if he still does that and why he does that. And also if he's quit smoking yet. I know he was interested in stopping smoking.
And stopping smoking, yes, that's the major thing in my life. I want to stop to smoke. But in superstitious way, I would say I'm a typical Mediterranean, and we have ancestrally that little things makes our lives a little superstition. But in any case, that's not very important in my life because I touch wood as soon as I feel the wood close to me.
Do you find American women more attractive than European women?
Well, I have to tell you, then first I'm not a professional lover. Like, people can think about me at all. I'm not Superman, I don't have any... I'm just a skinny guy who try to do the best he can, but if I had to say... And I think that there is not a concept which is better women or better people, human beings. Everybody has his own life, and there is not different nationalities for anything, for any reason, not different characters. Everybody is the same. When I was in China, for example, last week, and you imagine a China different, in the end, deep inside of that people, they feel like we feel, they love when they have to laugh, they cry when they have to cry, they are exactly the same than we are. So there is not a concept which is fulfilled in the women's in America better than the Europeans. They are human beings like everybody.
Yeah.
Could you sing something in German?
With your heart.
Achtung, die Was.
Wow.
I have two birthday kids here.
Yeah, you know what happened, my lady, then? When I used to sing in German 15 or 14 years ago, I remember that I used to go in the streets and people talk to me in German like they thought I speak German fluently. And I said, no, I'm only singing, not talking. And it was only phonetically. And it was, for me, the most difficult language to sing. I will sing after the show with you two words.
Very wise, yes.
Hi, I wanted to ask you if your career, I don't want to anger these people, but if your career were to die down, like, suddenly, do you have any other plans that you would like to do or anything?
If I have to finish my career and do something else?
Yeah, if you had to do something else, yeah.
Well, I will die. This is very difficult for an artist to answer a question, and we love when we die. Ask Phil if he will let the lights and will take the shadows once in his life. He will never take it.
I'd cut an album. We are in New York City with Julio Iglesias, and we'll be back in a moment. You are good enough to sing for us La Paloma.
Fue con su canto triste el otro.
Suspicion, that's a live voice, and the orchestra, of course, is taped, so this is live singing to tape. Hi.
Hi. You seem so humble.
Yeah.
No, he does. You seem very humble, and you seem very serious. And what my question is, even when you're singing, you seem like you're not here, you're somewhere else. Is it something that happened in your past, for instance, your accident with your back that makes you like
that? I'm not so humble, you think. I don't have that saint character, you think. I'm full of every complex you can imagine. I am not like you think. I'm vulnerable. I mean, I don't think that I'm so good, first. But when I'm singing, and happens to me since I start to sing, my skin, my body, my brains all together get younger. I don't want to miss that ever in my life because it's the only way that I feel that. But anything else, forget it. I am full of all the complex you want to ask me. So I don't think I am someone else. I'm completely Justin, and then...
You acknowledge insecurity, do you not?
This is one of the biggest things in my life. I'm very insecure. completely secure. I mean, if I had to be, no, I feel a little more confident now because I'm singing and I'm here with, and this looks like okay for me, but I'm very secure. I think I'm secure. Mm-hmm. Thank God also.
Yeah. 100 million sales will help.
No.
I believe you, however, and I thank you for your candor. Yes.
I was wondering, Phil mentioned you're a parent of three teenagers, and how did their music taste run? I know my half is loud.
You're teenagers. Incidentally, we have a photograph of that. Let me see these beautiful children, Brian. On the monitor, there they are. Well, that's the two sons. Obviously, the third was sent to his room just before this.
That's a cool thing.
There she is. Beautiful child.
They like everything except me. So they like Michael, they like Stevie, they like Lionel, they like everybody, but they are teenagers, they have to like another class of music.
I was wondering if you were planning to make any more albums in Italian, and also,
you are planning to make more babies on more albums.
And also, are your children interested in a musical career?
No, I don't think my children are interested in a musical career. I don't know exactly, they are too young now. But I plan to do albums until in any language until I die.
I was just wondering, who have been your heroes in your past of your life?
Which is the heroes in my life? The survivors. The survivors are my heroes. The people who survive, the fighters.
Those who come back from...
Exactly. They lose and they win again.
Hi, I want to know if there was ever anybody special in your life that you think about when you sing, or, you know, before your first marriage or since your divorce, you know?
Yes, there is, and she's in our audience.
There is always a special. There is always persons. Of course there is people, there is always happenings in your life who make you continue, but there is not somebody always, there is always something else. But not necessarily a human being, not necessarily a person. Yes. Something.
First, I'm happy to say I've come all the way from Canada to see you and Phil, and I'm thrilled. And the second thing is, how would you like the food in China? I thought it was awful.
Well, you know, in China, it's a very big contrast now. They look like they want to become very much Occidental now. They're trying to do the best they can. They're fighting also, they're building and building and building. They get much more approach to the Occidental culture. They're trying to make everything else better. But you have to love people, not for the kitchen. But the kitchen in China is still is developing. Even if they have interesting, beautiful things, they need more. They need more, but they will do it. They will do it.
We're in New York City with Julio Iglesias, and we'll be back in a moment. Boy, this is very unusual. La Paloma is not on this album. Everything else is nonstop. The title of Julio Iglesias' latest addition to your musical library. Are you? Let me see who's there. I'm glad you called. Go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Julio.
Yes.
Hi. I just want to tell you about a fabulous life that I lead, all because of you. Because I'm married to a man who looks exactly like you, and we just treat us so warmly that it's unbelievable. They open doors, they pull out chairs, they don't even believe when they tell my husband says that he's not you. And we enjoy a wonderful life because of his looking like you. And he's so
right. Maybe.
So successful.
Does your husband have an album he'd like to plug?
Maybe.
I'm sure you're flattered by that.
Yes.
And you'll behave if her husband will, huh? Yes.
Julio, how do you stay so trim or are you just lucky?
How I stay so trimless?
Trim. Thin.
Well, I think my father is like me, so this is
genetic. Yes.
But I do exercises too.
I don't speak Spanish. And you're being such a big superstar.
Yeah.
We're so glad that you came and that you conquered America.
Thank you.
You made us love you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yeah. Can you tell me,
who initiated the song we heard before in the first clip, you or Stevie? Who called who on it? Did you want to do the song with him, or did he want to do it with you?
No, he brought the song for myself, and he loved so much the song after that he decided to sing together, because it's a beautiful song. I think that Stevie is...
Let me show you. This is a video, and it's to be released as a single, or already is.
Yeah.
This is with Stevie. I believe these scenes are from our China. These are Chinascapes, are they not?
We were together in all the Oriental tour, and we just miss each other, and we do something like... Until he's coming back, we just make a clip from the Chinese ambience because it was doing in Beijing. This
in Beijing. Here's just a half a minute of this video. Stevie and Julio. Let my love shine. They like that very much. Yes, ma'am.
We love you. We love you.
We love you.
It's been a while since we've had the Supremes in our audience. Yeah.
I have two questions for you. First of all, my mother wants to know if you like older women. And second, you seem to have conquered the Europe before you came to the United States. Was that intentional, or did you try to make it in the States previously and not make
it? I only answered the first question of your mother. I'm very proud that the mothers in this country takes care of me the way they did, because every time they ask for an autograph in America, they said, my mother wants an autograph from you. So it makes me proud, because, you know, that people deserve many things, and they really fight for many things, and I love them very much. And I never conquer anything. I sing. I'm a singer. I think that was 500 years ago. I just singer, and I enjoy what happened to me as a singer. I don't conquer things. I just look to them and
over here.
I'd like to say that you sing very beautifully, and my question is, have you ever had any formal training in music, like voice lessons?
You did go to Cambridge, did you?
I went to England, yes, and I learned French.
You went to England to learn French. Are you not a lawyer?
I'm a lawyer, yes.
I see. Uh-huh.
Not a good
one. Yes. Yes.
You have sung your way around the world. Where do you live?
I live in the galaxy. I live in the moon. I live place to place. But I have a place in Miami, which is where my children are already, and this is the place that I stay more often. I don't have a place still. Looking for something
else. Isn't a love song in Spanish better?
No. Huh?
Am I wrong or what?
Spanish.
We got a riot breaking out here.
I'm an Spaniard. I'm a TV.
Well, I mean, for that reason,
It took me 8 years to learn English and to phrase in a little in English. Doesn't mean that I'm going to sing in English all my life. But for me, it has been so difficult to get in the language of this country and to learn to phrase it. Of course, it's natural in me to sing in Spanish, which is my life and my emotions and everything. Mm-hmm. But now I feel when I sing in English, then I don't have to think like before. Before, if I made this program with you, Phil, 2 years ago,
you'd have to concentrate.
I would never follow you. It will make me crazy here.
I know.
I will not understand anything.
Right. Not a few of our viewers have that problem with me today. And we'll be back with Julio Iglesias in just a moment.
wants this.
I don't want this, Jell. I can't. Wait a minute now. I have to retire to my quarters to decide who gets this. For reasons known only to somebody in our office, it's the only one we've got. Ladies and gentlemen, Julio Iglesias, love is on our side again, if you please, my good man, sir.
Sometimes just lips away.